Dear students, today we will talk about a novel but Vedic therapeutic system that is prevailed in Vedic India and has developed into very highly sophisticated system. And we will talk about it, and when you are here, you will do the practical of it. The system is known as Yajna therapy. You might have heard the word first time called Yajna, and we will talk little bit about it in the introduction. And Yajna therapy is also known as Yajnopathy. So, before we start the presentation, let us everybody put the attention into the one place. And to do that, let us all chant the word Om, the mantra Om together, and we will start the presentation. Om. Om. So now we will see the slides and we will go through the presentation. The presentation here is mostly theoretical. We will talk about the concepts, we will talk about the principles, we will talk about the hypothesis, why this system works, and we will talk a little bit about it, the procedure that you will do when you come here. So let us start the presentation. Here is the topic, Yajna therapy. What is Yajna therapy? This is your theoretical portion, and when you will visit here at Dev Sanskriti Vishwavidyalaya, you will be given a practical demonstrations. So first we will have to understand its principles, its therapeutic concepts, its background, its versatile utility, and how, what you will do when you come here. So let us first start the presentation, and we will go through each portion step by step. So first, this is the main slide. And here we can see that this is a Vedic therapeutic system, and that you might have seen the Yajna first time today. So in the consecutive, in this video, you will hear, you will see a video regarding Yajna that is being performed here. So this Yajna is an ancient ritual, that is a Vedic ritual. And Indian scriptures says there are two main sources of Indian culture. So Indian culture we can say in easy languages, there are two main categories, two main sources through which Indian culture has originated. So one is called Gayatri and the other is called Yajna. Gayatri is known as a righteous knowledge, while Yajna is known as righteous deeds. So Yajna is a very big terminology, and it has a very special place in India and Indian culture, Indian traditions. But here we will just talk about its therapeutic aspect. But before going to the therapeutic aspect, we will go a little bit about its other aspects and get the idea regarding the broader view. So Yajna can be understood by two categories. One is Gyan, that is known as wisdom, and the other is Vigyan. So mostly in Vigyan we can consider rituals. So what is here, we will mostly focus on Vigyan portion in the therapeutic aspect. The basic meaning of Yajna. So Yajna word is originated from three terminologies. One is Dev Pujan, second is Sangatikaran, third is Dan. So let us understand this as a broader perspective. Dev Pujan is to worship for, is, it is known as to worship for good qualities and virtues. So in Dev Pujan, we try to imbibe, we try to get the good qualities and virtues from the higher sources. While in Sangatikaran, we try to imbibe and amplify those qualities so we can utilize it for better purposes. And the third is Dan, so to utilize this amplified gained qualities and virtues for welfare of the other people. So how does this fit into the different systems? So the scripture says that this fundamental three things happens into any systems. So, gaining of the qualities, virtues or energy, amplification, and then passing into it, so the system or the cycle can survive. So, using this principle, Indian rishis, Indian sages has implied this novel tech, this ancient Vedic ritual into various dimensions. So, the first dimension we can say it's a spiritual dimension to get the spiritual development. Other is a health dimension to health, get the health benefits, environmental dimensions to get the social harmony, to get the political harmony, to get the inside spiritual harmony into people's mind, then also to balance with the nature and to the ecology. So, there are different dimensions, there are different protocols, and but here when you visit the campus, we will mostly talk about the yajna therapy, the therapeutic aspect regarding the health. So, let us see what is the problem with the modern therapeutic applications, what are their limitations. So, we have to understand that when we apply the modern allopathic treatment or other modern treatments, there are some limitations, not in every systems, but there are mostly they are seen that there is side effects, there is resistance, recurrence. This resistance and recurrence is seen mostly into the complicated diseases. Recovery is poor with these therapeutic systems, survival rate is low when there are complicated diseases. So, what is the system that is not only considered one aspect of during the treatment, that considers various aspects in treating the patient. So, there is a need of novel therapy that is felt today, and the solution lies in Vedic therapeutic model that we are talking. So, what is yajna therapy? Now, we will consider its therapeutic aspect and we will see the definition with that perspective. So, ancient Vedic method, this is ancient Vedic method, yajnapathy, that in this one we do pulmonary inhalation of multiple herbs through utilization of mantras in the presence of fire, while whatever is generated into the medicinal smoke through use of disease specific herbs, that smoke is actually result of the transformation of the material into the vapor phase, and that has phytomedicines and other nutritional things that is giving a therapeutic advantage. What is yajna therapy, the therapeutic aspect mentioned in Vedas or Indian scripture? What are the sources? So, first let us see what is the scripture says about yajna therapy, then we will discuss about what is in the present time and what you will do, what is the status while you perform these things, what is the status till then. So, the Vedas are full of references regarding the treatment of various diseases and conditions through yajna. Conditions such as physiological, psychological, emotional, spiritual ailments and diseases, they all are covered into the Vedic literature, and the Vedic literature described treating these all conditions and ailments through yajna. Here we will see little bit more about little bit of examples. So, for example, Rig Veda states, Rig Veda 3 chapter 3 sub chapter 10 and then shloka 3 states that in the fire of yajna, human being who obligates various herbs in divine fire gets strengthened and nurtured. So, the yajna described in Veda not only talked about treating diseases, it also talked about various to maintain the health conditions in all the states, in different conditions, how to maintain the health, continuous good health. Here we will see that Atharvaveda refers yajna therapy for various disease conditions such as warm conditions, warm infections, fevers, mania, goiter. There are many described in Vedas, but we will just talk about right now a few references that we are giving to you. Just to give you an idea that the Vedas are literally full of references regarding yajna for treating various conditions. The another system in India that is considered is since Vedic time, that is called Ayurvedic system. And in Ayurveda also, the use of fire for generating medicinal smoke is described, and that is also considered portion of the yajna. That terminology in Ayurveda of yajna is known as dhumnasya or nasya, basically in which herbal fumes are generated to treat various disease conditions. Okay, now we have to see little bit of example how what Ayurvedic text says. So these are just references for your knowledge. You can read little bit in detail later on, but various disease conditions and different formulas are being recommended in various Ayurvedic scriptures. So Vedas, Ayurvedic literature, everything, every ancient literature described yajna for treating various conditions, various ailments, including psychological conditions. But what is its status today? So we have to understand that in 1979, a research effort, a systematic research effort started by Brahmavarchasva Shodh Sansthan, that is founded by the founder of this organization that you are going to visit, and it under his direct guidance, Shraddhaya Dr. Pranab Pandya, who is the chancellor of the university, has started this investigation into this novel concept. He and his team has made a tremendous hard work and rejuvenated this whole system, and which result that you will experience while you are here. Here we can see that there is a picture shown here on the right, and this is the lab, which lab you will, it is a part of, it's a lab in Brahmavarchasva Research Institute, which you will visit when you are here. That's a part of your curriculum. And here there is a lab of yajna therapy lab. Over there you can see there is a big glass chamber, and the yajna is performed, and its medicinal smoke is being tested through various scientific equipments. And the patients normally sits around here, and then they inhale this fume to get the therapeutic advantage. So the result of this institute came in one book. They gave 80 types of formulas regarding various disease conditions, various normal conditions to seasonal conditions, and from there 30 major herbal formulations are being made here. And patients visit here since past 10 years at this university, and they are being prescribed at the center of Ayurveda studies. And they take these herbs and they go home and then follow the protocol and then inhale these medicinal fumes and then get benefited. So we will talk this little bit in the last of the presentation. But the research effort has also been made. So we can see here that these all are the dissertation done here at the universities, at this university. One study by Dr. Raghuvanshi on 15 patients on tuberculosis patient showed that ex vivo sputum of this patient treated, yajna therapy treated patients, when grown into the culture, 75% bacterial growth reduction was observed, while Vata disorder patients were also got benefited, HIV AIDS patients also got benefited, and mental health also was improved through yajna. So various applications of yajna is being into the research pipeline here and being tested vigorously. Vedic literature not only described yajna therapy as for treating only health condition or physiological conditions, they also talked yajna therapy not only on those physiological systems, but also for spiritual, also for the diseases. Those are occurred due to the problems way inside, due to the emotional problem, due to the psychological problem. So we will talk this little bit in detail, but we consider yajna as a comprehensive and complete therapeutic system. And why it is that, we will go through that into the presentation and understand it. In Vedic times, before we talk about its a principle, but let us understand what was the status of this therapeutic system in Vedic time. And in Vedic time, this system was highly sophisticated lead developed, very sophisticated lead developed, and very detailed protocols were there for various conditions. So, over the at that time, the hospitals were not there. There were Gurukuls and RNACs, the asylum for students learning, for educating people. Those were Gurukuls and RNACs. Over there, the yagya therapy was given to patients and whoever is needed. Over there, protocols included not only specific herbs, that included specific material that is used in the yagya. For example, specific ghee, the butter made out of the specific animal's milk, in specific disease condition it was prescribed, specific rituals of what the preparation of the patient would be, what the preparation, what kind of mantras would be used. These all were very detailedly prescribed and highly sophisticated developed. But unfortunately, this is lost due to during the medieval time in Indian history, and this whole effort of Brahmavarcha Research Institute to revive and reconnect those lost pieces, though available pieces, and rejuvenate the whole, rejuvenate this whole system through novel, through the available modern research equipments. Now, we will understand the components of the yagya therapy. So, you all might be interested in knowing that this is a novel Vedic therapeutic system, but how does it work? How, what is the scientific support behind its working? So, that's what we will talk in next slides, and at the end we will just summarize what you will do here, and that will be the end of the presentation. Here we can see that there are different components of the yagya therapy. According to Yug Rishi Pandit Sri Ram Sharma Acharya, there are five main components of yagya therapy that is giving its a therapeutic giving a therapeutic advantage. So, one is the application of mantras, that is also separately used as enchantment therapy. The other is the use of fire, so heat therapy, and then material transformation principle is used in various other systems. Use of herbal material, that is used in Ayurveda and other herbal treatments. So, that is ethnopharmacological concept is involved. Utilization of sun energy and its power. So, this is a very novel concept to the science, but the literature is available to support it. We will talk about it. And then implication of participants' emotions. So, there is lot of literature available for this aspect also. So, these all are very important in giving an overall therapeutic outcome. So, this is the model that we will talk little bit and mostly discuss in upcoming slides. So, here we can see that the emotions of the person conducting the yagya, it is a central portion into the therapeutic system. Then there are three other main, is a use of mantra, use of herbs, disease specific herbs, use of fire. So, use of fire has a very different advantage, that is very much described in Indian literature, and once you are here we will talk more about it, that how that fire component is more important. Because it is not only just physical fire that is important, the fire, generation of the fire and every aspect that is important. So, we will talk about it when you are here. But important portion is fire, mantra and herbs, they all interact with each other. Fire and mantra interaction is important, so amplification of the mantra energy is we can see. Herbs has to be properly ignited and go into the vapor phase. So, fire and herbs has to interact each other. Mantra is the vibration, and that science of mantra in generating the proper utilization of herbs has also to be used. So, this is called the system. In this system, what is seen that when you make the smaller portion of anything, that gives the more advantage. The sublimization of any material, it increases the potency of the material. So, when the material is put into the fire, and with the use of mantra, with the use of fire, it is made into the very subtle form, into the gaseous form, and then more subtle form. So, that is more potent than the herbs actually, what it is. So what happens is in that one, the subtle power gives much more potency, and this is what seen is a similar concept in what is seen into the homeopathic system. And if you have more, if you have any questions regarding this, how exactly this transformation occurs, we will see a little bit here, but we will also talk when you are here. The lastly important portion is the utilization of the sun energy. So how this model is working? So let's go a little bit in detail. Okay, what happen is yagya energy is actually everything outcome of this five factor interaction among each other is a yagya energy. So herbs, fire, and mantra, they all interact with each other, and there is scientific evidence available that individually application of herbs, individual application of fire and mantra, there is not much evidence available about fire and mantra, but for herbs it is available that herbs is capable of causing changes in cellular and molecular signaling. And just for your information, that cellular and molecular signaling is very important in any diseases. Cellular molecular signaling changes happens due to the disease, and any drug that is used, that is also cause the changes in cellular and molecular mechanisms. So that is a different branch of study, but evidence is available that herbs has the phytomedicine that is cause the changes in cellular and molecular signaling. Sun is known to change into the psychology of the person and is associated with the molecular associated with the disease conditions, and also associated with the cellular molecular signaling to circadian cycle. Emotion is also associated. So we will talk this, that we say that all this together cause changes in psychoneuroimmunity. They all causes changes in the psychology of the person, their thoughts, their emotions, and even physiology. And these changes in psychology, what it does affect the person's hormonal gland system, and that hormonal gland system is the one actually controlling the cellular molecular mechanism of the body. So this is the model that we are hypothesizing. Here is the slide for your study, that Rig Veda. Now we will talk each component one by one. So let us first talk about the herbs, the generation of medicinal smoke through yagya. And Rig Veda supports that when we inhale any medicinal smoke, it actually gives us the strength to fight against the disease, and then when he expel, it takes out the disease out of the body. So this is the Vedic literature available, and modern science also support that pulmonary administration of vapor at aromatic level is very important in very various conditions. Clinical trials using aromatic compounds of or aroma of the herbs has been done already on cancer patients and on other diseases. And it is shown that herbal has the potential in the form of phytomedicines, in the form of its aroma, that is helpful to the patient. While a study by Joshi et al. In 2006 here at the university, they also done the pharmacokinetic modeling, and then showed that the administration of pulmonary route is more potent, 1.5 times potent than the administration through the IV route. So this says that this is not a novel concept, and it is powerful through give the herbs through pulmonary inhalation. While various studies here at the bottom shown that various studies already into the modern science shows that herb has phytomedicines that is helpful for generating the therapeutic outcome. Mantra, now it is recent studies are emerging regarding mantra, how it is doing the changes in the psychology of the person, neural changes, and eventually affecting the human health. So we believe that the mantra, they all cause the changes in psychology, they all contribute into the thinking pattern of the person, and at the end they gives the outcome into the form of psychoneuroimmunity and to the disease condition. There are various other modes of action also, but we are mainly focusing on psychoneuroimmunity right now. Application of mantra along with medicinal fumes. Science of mantra is also known, that we will not go into much detail, but this slide is for your reference. This is also for your reference. Now, we will talk more about emotions. Emotion of the person is very important. Now, recent studies have shown that emotions play a vital role in human health, and through regulation of psychoneuroimmunity axis, and it does the molecular signaling and affects the imparts the therapeutic outcome. And here are some references. This is for your easy understanding. I made a table that take a disease for an example, that emotions is highly associated with cancer risk, and various studies have already shown that the emotions of the person, the negative emotions of the persons, is highly associated with the risk of the cancer. Another study says that emotions, the such as loneliness or sad depression, this all outcome actually affects your immunity, and that eventually affects your outcome. And in yagya, what happens in yagya, it overall the use of mantra, fires, the herbs that all contains aroma, the fire, the energy of sun, they all affects together persons to come out of their psychological complexes. This is also one study by Dr. Steve Cole at the University of California. They also took the blood of the lonely people and then said that there are inflammatory genes are increased into this kind of people. So, this is also for your reference to understand that how emotions play an important role and how yagya does. There is various literature available, the traditional literature, and our practical experience over here at the Center of Ayurveda Studies says that it is actually improving patients even emotional and psychological status. Sun energy, this is a very novel concept. This is an important study by Dr. I'm not sure who is he, but the group by Hursky, they actually done a detailed study and published the paper in Astrobiology, and they say that the sun spot cycle that comes every 11 year, normally comes at 11 year, and that is highly associated with person's physiology and pathophysiological condition. They said various mechanisms regarding it, but we will not go into detail, but you can refer that paper, the citation is given. But important thing is the sun is already known to control the human sleep, human genes, various good scientific publications including into the Science magazine, they already said that. I haven't included that reference here, but I can give you once you are here. So, in that one they already said that that human whole genes, every cell has a circadian cycle, every cell has genes and proteins, they have circadian cycle, and this all is associated with pineal and pituitary gland, that is into our brain, and this is very important that through that they control our whole disease condition. So, in yagya, through the use of mantra, through the use of person's emotions, we try to utilize that energy, and that, for example, fire transforms the herbs. Mantra's effect is also shown here. Yagya energy interactions of person's emotions, that was also shown, is written here, and emotions of the person that actually connect the person to the yagya energy, connects the yagya energy to the sun energy, and we hypothesize that this whole complex interactions happen. So, this is the model that again I am showing to you, and lastly we will talk about what we are doing here. So, here in since past 10 years we are prescribing more than 30 types of herbal formulas to the patients, and each formula contains various herbs, some contains 15 herbs, some contains 40 herbs, and these herbs are disease specific, condition specific, and into that one patient takes it, go at home and implies that, and they give us the feedback, that is also the publication is also in pipeline and few are also published, we can see that they are getting tremendous advantage. Here is the list of Havan Samagri that we are prescribing. And this is for your reference, that fever, cardiac problems, pregnancy issues, depression, sleep issues, cancer, tuberculosis, mental issues, psychological issues, eye problem, HIV related diseases, paralysis, skin diseases, kidney diseases, liver and spleen diseases. So, we have made almost, we have tried to cover all the systems that is one's problem in that causes the disease condition. There is one more factor besides these principles of the yajna that we have described. The use of proper wood that we make the fire, that is also important in getting therapeutic outcome. Use of the proper equipment to generate the fumes, to generate the utilize of the person's emotions and the energy of the sun, proper channelization has to be made. So, there is a particular shape, different shapes are recommended in the scripture, but we are using mostly this one for patient's prescription. And there is a samagri, that is herbal formulation, just that herbal 30 formulation that we have described. And this is a protocol, but you will do, once you are here, you will do the actual practical, and we will make sure that you get this whole experience and learn this protocol and imply that that we will do when you are here. But mostly we make sure that after the generation of medicinal fume, patient or the person who wants to utilize the benefit of the fume sits into that environment and do the pranayama inhalation for at least 15 minutes. So, we like to welcome you and wait for your visit here. Thank you.